game, which is, after all, it had to be a goal at some point. I'm sure it is.
You know, we will eventually know, and in November, first week of November, we'll play somebody.
We know that we're going to have three teams in, and it is a chance for a wild card as well. And we're going to have to play Friday night's ball game. And well, we've got a lot of teams that come under this criteria right here. But, hey, the team that is clearly really good and clearly well-coached and clearly very hungry is the Blackman Blaze, and they're coming to your place, and they are very good.
Yeah, they've done a great job over there. You know, they've had some good young teams over there over the past few years. And, it'd be a great game. You know, that's the Blackman community is very close to the Riverdale community. And, I'll say this. Our kids are going to show up, and we'll be accountable. We'll be accountable.
They bring some serious problems. Maybe y'all are very much alike. A lot of good people can carry the mail at both schools.
Yeah. Well, I think first and foremost, both schools play good defense, and that's what wins football games. And, when you play good defense, that gives yourself a chance to play. And then, obviously, they have a good ground game, and we hope we do. And, it should be a lot of fun. I mean, again, the pressure's off both schools as far as there's no playoff, ramifications. It'll
you're both going to get in.
Except for maybe, again, the top spot. And obviously that's big. But it should be exciting.
Chris Mays will be at right tackle, number 79. Jake Steen at tight end, number 18. Marcellus Odoms, number 2, at running back, along with Adam Davenport, number 5, and C.J. Overton. Quinton Sherrill is going to play tonight. We'll get back the rest of it in just a second.
Grayson Powell kicks it through the end zone. It'll be 1st and 10 from the 20 for the Blackman Blaze.
Going to see Oh, man.
So Deshaun Smith has another opportunity.
Well, he boomed one. If he gets another one like that, Riverdale will take it for sure.
Ron Adelot's questioning what happened.
Tom Hoover tells me that the wind is blowing from the west, and right now it looks somewhat still. It's not quite as bad as it was.
After the initial front passage, brings a little gusty conditions and rain, and then the rain is going to fall here for the next several hours. Now they're asking for a dry football.
Is this supposed to last all night tonight, this rain?
A good deal of the night, about 12 hours of rain when it starts, so it'll be a soggy start to Saturday morning. If you have a golf outing early tomorrow morning, it could be a little wet. Ready to kick it off here once again, which is going to delay our Mullins Jewelry kickoff time. That was just a prelude. Now 2 minutes later, the toe is in it, and it's going to be returnable by Deshaun Smith. However, went through his hands and was in pretty good condition. That will deteriorate as we go through the evening. Tyreek Collier in at quarterback, twins to either side. Hand off to the tailback Joyce for a yard. And 8.5 yards to go. Just underway, no score in the District 7 AAA title game. Smith with the same set as before. Jacques Smith to block. Quick pass out right side to Crutchfield, and Crutchfield's going to be driven back. But he gets
this year, and they've just gotten better as the year progressed.
Tay Smith is one of two receivers to the far side. Blackman moving left to right in the white uniforms, which will soon be transformed to a dark brown. Collier passing near side and incomplete, intended for Dietrich. Jason Poor in to punt on fourth down. Marcellus Odom standing back at his own 40. Nice high kick. It's going to take a bounce. And it's going to take a Blackman roll down to the 25-yard line.
So quickly, Brian, Jeff Pitts, a avid listener of ours, listening tonight along with my sister, Nancy Stewart, at home, usually out here at the ballpark.
Up the middle. Ball comes loose late, but.
Yeah, you sure did. I think he just maybe has a sting or shaking up a little bit, but good to see him walk off.
Donnie Johnson with a Steve Martin Construction Field Report. back to play here. And quarterback Cody West keeps it. And another 2 or 3 yard gain there.
A lot of Riverdale has the last few games.
West is back to pass. Quick pass left side is going to be caught down the sideline. Goes Adam Davenport, but he's pushed out around the 30. Charles Martin breaks the huddle and sets him down. West going to work behind center. I believe that's Odom or Smith behind West. Line in tight. Hard count by West. And Cody calls a timeout.
And 101.9 AM 1450 and goinsidesports.com.
So on fourth and inches, Riverdale is going to go for it a second time, and they get a massive offensive line push. And
they used the timeout on that, but it was a kind of a quick snap and a good quarterback sneak for a first down.
West is going to keep it again this time and going to be hit and hit and hit and hit again. Taken down right there at the third. Helmets and pants. Eric Wallen, receiver, far side, lone receiver. Now another out there to join him. The pass is to Odom, right side. Odom to the 44-yard line. Miles Peppers, near side receiver. That's the wide side. Odom gets it, loses it, fumbled the football away, and I have no idea. Let's see who comes up with it. The official is down there. Still no indication. Ball was loose. Who's in the bottom of the pile? It's going to be Riverdale football.
They took a long time getting up off the pile, and there for a minute, I think Blackman really did think they had it, but it's Riverdale's ball, going to punt it away.
Odom just mishandled the handoff. Slippery ball there tonight. And here is the punt by Grayson Powell, and what a punt. It's going to be returned from the 10. And we've got Deshaun Smith rolled down at the 10, and there's a flag. Breaking the huddle with Tay Smith, near side receiver. They're moving left to right. Dietrich far side. Eye backfield for Collier. Hand off left side. Still on his feet is Deshaun Smith. He's at the 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Crosses over midfield at the 45 and pushed out of bounds. Donnie Johnson on the sidelines for Steve Martin Construction, 904-9639. High backfield here again, and tailback. 5:58 to play in the first, no score. Matthew Stubbs over the football under center is Tyreek Collier. To Smith, left side. He's at the 45, 40, 35, 30. It's a foot race, and nobody's going to catch Octavius Smathers. Touchdown, Blaze!
Opened up a beautiful hole, and then nobody converged. I think Riverdale had a lot of people up at the line of scrimmage, and nobody was in the backfield or the secondary to pick him up. And, boy, he kicked it into high gear, didn't he? High-stepping.
To the end zone for the TD to give Blackman a 6-0 lead. Jason Poor for point. Snap. Splits the uprights.
Four plays, 1 minute and 11 seconds, Brian. It all it took for Blackman to take a 7-0 lead.
5:45 left here in the first. Jason Poor to kick off.
Now here comes the rain.
And the wind.
And the rain. And there's some more wind.
And a lot more rain. Umbrellas and ponchos are sold out here in Murfreesboro tonight. And here's the kickoff. High and wobbling. Returnable. But only to the 15-yard line.
The Blackman offensive line is doing a great job right now.
Thank you, Don. Handoff goes left side. The ball squirts loose late, and I think Blackman has recovered the fumble. If they say he's down, maybe.
I think it's going to be River.
That could have been really bad for the Warriors. Miles Peppers far right. Nobody left side. Odom in motion. Empty backfield, and Cody West is going to keep it and be slung down at the line of scrimmage. Tried to go
before here, would you imagine?
I would think so. Radar showed that they had some rain there north of town. Odom going right side and picks up about 2 yards. John Smith is standing back at his own 40-yard line. Ready to receive the punt from Powell. It's high, but Smith is going to take it and be wrestled down at the 37-yard line. Maybe the 38, depends on.
So this is going to be a wet, sloppy game.
All right, Don, thank you. Donnie Johnson with our Steve Martin construction field report.
Not water absorbing.
Water absorbing. Well, it is on your side.
We'll have a little check here in a minute.
Second and 9. 2 in the backfield. 1 receiver to either side for Collier. Handoff comes near side, and Smith. Mathers at tailback, Joyce at fullback. Tay Smith, receiver near side. It's Mathers. Mathers going to be bottled up and slung down. Jason Poor is in to punt. In a driving rain. Gets off a nice one. Taken at the 30. Diving forward. First and 10 for Riverdale from their 32. Handoff up the middle. Could get a paper plate from the...
As long as that jacket's okay, we're okay.
It's rolling off of it, looks like. Back to pass is West. He's looking near side. Got plenty of time. Now he's going to tuck it and run. And is up to the 35-yard line. Over the football, Charles Martin. Huge play for the Riverdale offense. And the handoff is to tailback Odom, I believe.
InsideSports.com.
Grayson Powell is in to punt. Deshaun Smith back at his 30. Field conditions are getting pretty rough. Powell with another boomer. And Deshaun Smith caught it, bounced out, and then landed on it.
Boy, that
at the
fell,
34.
Brian, that fell right in front.
First and 10 now for the Blaze. Moving right to left as we see it to open up the quarter. They lead it 7-0. Collier fakes the handoff, being pursued, and he better get rid of it, and does to Dietrich at the 42-yard line. Odom with the four
by Mathers,
which was set up by a big return from Deshaun Smith. High backfield for Collier. Collier the handoff, Mathers, I believe, and he is slung down. Second and 13. Smith going to work from the shotgun on the second and long. Has some protection, some time, and the pass is miraculously caught by Tay Smith.
Collier just to get it in there.
First down. 7-0 Blaze, and they're moving. Fumble, ball in the backfield, picked up by Miles Peppers. MartinConstruction.com.
Collier was having some problems in the pregame warm-ups, trying to hold on to the football. You could tell he was kind of disgusted, and that was a case of it with the really heavy rain coming.
Pitch back. Waiting on a few blockers is Cheryl.
He's down, I believe.
Loose ball. Second and five. Ball at the Blackman 46. West back to pass, surveying. Pass is caught by Cheryl at the 40. Still on his feet, won't go down. They finally wrestle him to the turf at the...
Nothing fancy about that play, just Cheryl coming out of the backfield looking as a safety valve for West, and he threw him a strike.
Man in motion is Davenport, gets the pitch. Goes up the left
as well, back to what it did before the game started. This may be the front coming through here.
Maybe. The rain really coming down now. Second down and eight. Davenport trying to go left side.
It's going to be some rain for a while.
Third down for Riverdale. And six to go. West back to pass. Looking across the middle. Has plenty of time. Flushed out of the pocket. Now makes a quick pass right side. And it is going to be caught by Waltz Gaines. It is that here at Riverdale tonight. Riverdale with a fourth and seven. Cody West is in here on fourth down from the Blackman 35. West from the shotgun, sending three receivers left side. Pass is incomplete, intended for Miles Peppers.
So now Blackman wants, what they want to do here now is establish some running game and try to eat up some clock and even maybe get down there and score again.
Collier barking the signals to Mathers. Mathers just will not go down. Finally wrestled down at the 41 for huddle. Jalen Smith, receiver wide side, far side. Near side receiver, Tay Smith. Eye backfield for Collier. And whistles and a flag. And are marching right to left. Smith. Tay Smith near side. Another receiver out there far side. Mathers on the carry. Mathers will. Third and three. Tay Smith far side, John.
Big hold here. A big hold here for Riverdale. And Blackman wanting to get first down.
Jalen Smith near side receiver. Mathers the tailback. Fullback Joyce. And Collier gets out of one tackle. But he's going to be slung down. Chris Mays' mother, who's suffering from an autoimmune disease and recovering and doing a lot better, we understand, and she may be listening in tonight. Snap goes over Jason's head. Poor to get off the punt. It's blocked. And they're going to roll down to the corner of the end zone. And it is going to be recovered by the Riverdale Warriors, Chris Mays.
Tonight that we probably haven't seen all year due to these conditions.
For the tying extra. Snap, set, kick is up by Powell.
1450 WGNS and go insidesports.com.
Welcome into prep football coverage on WGNS. Boy, John, that was an exciting play, and that was definitely weather caused.
Yeah, it wasn't exciting for Blackman, was it?
Was not. Was for Riverdale.
That's what's going to happen tonight on some of these things.
Deshaun Smith on the kickoff. Going to be wrestled down at the 20. You're exactly right, Brian.
Well, he's talking.
I hear him.
Yes.
Well, I'm not sure where he is. Flag flies. Penalty. We'll back him up.
Well, Blackman needs to be careful here.
First and 21 now from their nine. Deshaun Smith is back there left side. Getting more and more difficult to see the numbers as they are mud covered. Here is Collier. Back to pass, three-step drop, right side, threw it away. Third down and long. Working from the shotgun. Pass out, right side. Dietrich makes the catch, but slung down after. Odom is standing at the 50. Oh, this one is almost through his hands. He one-hands it, picks it up, and gets off a nice kick. It bounces and goes out of bounds at the 39. That Blackman tried to get off. It went over the head of Jason Poor and was picked up finally in the end zone by Chris Mays. West rolling out right side, passing downfield, and intended for Wallen. It is incomplete.
Snap over the punter's head for that touchdown really looms large now for Blackman.
Rain slowing up here a bit. Pass back to Sherrill on the pitch. Sherrill to the 30. This is the wet weather that we all expected.
Yeah, this is a downpour now, folks.
Third down, West passing. It's going to be caught, covered in mud.
Well, if you think that's bad, try punting.
Which is what Grayson Powell is going to attempt.
I shanked it
high, and he did shank it. Going to take a bounce to the 25-yard line. So 70.
This is the worst rain we've seen. You know,
at least it's not thundering and storming.
No, but it's the heaviest rain we've ever been in, I think.
It is. And we're looking through umbrellas, so we'll do the best we can. Collier barking at the line. I think he bobbled the handoff. Goes right side and took a timeout. So we will take one as well with 32.7 left. 7-7 your score left here before. Blackman on the second and seven with only 32.7 left before half. Deshaun Smith with a quarterback sneak right up the middle. Not much there, trying to strip the football away. Clock run. Fans Heating and Air, the Church Street Shoney's, Craig's Tax Service, and Jerry Potts Car Care. John, you mentioned a few minutes ago how it's really a shame that this game has been so marred by the weather. This second half, even if the rain were to stop now, is going to be very sloppy. So this is not a real true test of both of these teams. But you got to play with the conditions you're dealt.
And everybody's playing on the same field. So you look at it that way, you just do the best you can.
There is water all over the field. I mean, it's just standing all over the field. This is would make for a fun backyard game, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it almost looks like it's just as slick as glass, doesn't it?
It sure does.
A coat of ice is on it. And only they know how good the traction is, but I would think it's pretty miserable.
Jason Poor is ready to kick off to Riverdale, who won the toss and deferred to the second half. Tied at seven, and the toe is in the football. Ready for the second half, and it is going to be muffed by Davin.
But somebody's got to score to win this game, and I really don't think you want to try and go in overtime, so we'll see what they have under their sleeve here.
Just underway here in the second half. Right to left, Riverdale with the football, and Cody West is going to keep it. Has the outside corner as the mud splashes, and he's going to be ridden out of bounds around the 36-yard line here, working from the right hash in the biggest mud puddle on the field. West is going to keep it again and be ridden down at the line of scrimmage. Second. Martin breaks the huddle, sets him down on the second down, 9 to go. They did give West officially about a half a yard. We've played a minute. Play going up the middle, right side, and really not much room there. Where else would you want to be?
Yeah, I mean, it's great. This is football.
West with a third and 8. Fakes it, goes right side, dives forward, back at the line of scrimmage.
By going over the punter's head, but so far Powell's handled it pretty good. I think he shanked one, his last one. But, boy, that was in a very torrential downpour at that time.
It is not as heavy as it was then. He takes an extra step here and booms one through the hands of Martin Dietrich. He picks it up on the run down the right sideline. 30, 35, 36, 37, ridden out of bounds. I tell you that because it's important for Smyrna's hopes to get into the playoffs that both of those teams who are leading now win. First and 10 for the Blaze. Collier to Mathers, I believe, crossing midfield. Was marked ready for play at the 49 of Riverdale. Martin sets him down. Joyce and Mathers in the backfield. Changing the play at the line is Collier. He goes left side with Mathers, and he's going to be yanked down behind the line of scrimmage.
Trouble getting a push, particularly that offensive line getting a push off that surface in order to get enough to make a block.
The line is where the game's going to be won here tonight, and it's
you're definitely correct there.
Going to be a tough night for both lines. Third and long, third and seven. Mathers, the handoff, low goes left side. Still on his feet, keeps him churning. He's at the 45, at the 40, and he gets down to around the 36, 30.
Don, he really keeps those legs moving, doesn't he?
He sure does, and the first guy usually doesn't stop him either.
Donnie Johnson on the sidelines for Steve Martin Construction online at stevemartinconstruction.com. Play is blown dead by... Well, Riverdale's offense has not scored. It was their defense that tied this ball game up. And Blackman's score came early when it was the field conditions were much better. Back to pass on the first and 15. Long pass down the left sideline is incomplete.
Oh, yeah, it's not because of, yeah, it's the turf. That's all it is.
And then you tend to overthrow. Second and 15 for Collier. Fumbled by Mathers. I think he has recovered the fumble. It'll be third down and a loss of about a yard. John, I can just see
but that ball is kind of like just slick as glass right now. They wipe it off, but there's so much rain coming down, Brian, you can't hold on to
it. Well, once you put the ball down on the turf, it's just like floating. Third and 16. Ball carrier is Deshaun. Snap is good on the punt, and it's a nice one. Odom fair catches it. No, he didn't. I thought he fair caught it. There's a flag, and he tried to return it. So that could be trouble.
Riverdale could really use a first down here just to get out of trouble. Blackman, of course, their job is to keep them right there.
And it's going to be a quarterback keeper.
Steve probably warmed up to a cozy fire right now.
Probably so. Second and 10 with no loss on the play. West decides to keep it again and goes down at the line of scrimmage again. Now
I can figure.
West is going to work from under center. No receivers. One tailback. Cheryl is in motion. Play coming right up the left side to about the 10-35.
And don't forget, he had a good run back on the last punt of 30 yards.
Here's Powell. They don't bring much pressure, but it's a short punt. It's going to bound around and roll dead. Right around. Prentice Alsop Heating and Air. The Smyrna Bowling Center. Mullins Jewelry. Tennessee Orthopedic Alliance. And Murfreesboro Electric. Joyce and Mathers in the backfield. Mathers with the handoff right up the middle. Second down and a yard. Ball now at the 22 of Riverdale. Blackman moving left to right. Joyce and Mathers lined up in the eye. Mathers again. Going left side. And splashes in the...
You know, even a field goal is not a given.
No.
This kind of weather.
First and 10 for the Blaze. Collier to Mathers. Mathers up.
Want to get it around that 10-yard line if I even going to attempt a field goal.
Jason Gann is in at fullback, a senior for Blackman. Mathers is your tailback. Second and 8. Ball fumbled. It's lost, and Riverdale, I think, has recovered it. Yes. Who is that one?
I wouldn't be surprised if Cody West doesn't keep the ball a lot on this next possession for Riverdale.
Well, he did on the previous possession. Thanks, Don. Gives it off to Odom right side. Odom tries to dive forward.
The quagmire.
That's very true. Just think what this field's going to look like the next time that a game's played here. It's going to be a lot of work on it this week, I can tell you that. 34 seconds, waning moments here of the third. Cody West decides to keep it. Cool. Cookeville leading Coffee County 45-0. See if we can't run across some a few other scores here for you. We also understand that Cordova has now taken a 16-13 lead over Bolton. Play from scrimmage from the 20. Now first and 10 for Riverdale. 0-1 and 0-2 is when Riverdale and Blackman played in the regular season and in the playoffs. Coming near side is Odom. Slung down by the between the two schools. We just don't know who the victor is going to be. Right now, we're tied at 7. Carrying the ball right like Hunter Thompson. For Blackman. Gaines on the third down and 7.
The punt, guys. Another adventure. Let's see what happens.
Another adventure. You holding up well down there?
Yes. Doing well.
All right. Donnie Johnson on the sidelines for Steve Martin Construction. Here's the Grayson Powell punt, and this one's pretty good. It's going to take a bounce and just drop dead. And Deshaun Smith, number one in the district, and likely overall number one seeds in their quadrant, beginning the playoffs next week. Ball fumbled. The snap was bad. And it John, any score could be huge.
Well, I think any score wins it, really, I mean, at this point.
Right now tied at 7 apiece. 9:19 showing left in regulation. Mathers coming near side and hit at the back.
This Patton's been all over the place.
He has.
For Blackman, and let's don't take away the good play by the defense, even though the weather's bad.
Collier working under center this time on the third and long. Fake goes right side. Collier's going to keep it himself and be ridden down for a loss. Whiteman has had some trouble with these punts tonight.
Oh, boy, have they.
That's what tied us up. Riverdale fans saying block that kick.
Oh,
and they almost did. It's going to bound out of bounds and right around the 46-yard line. I think there's a small divot in the turf out there now. Brandon Constant giving up the body.
Brian, somebody's going to have to get serious here when it comes to trying to move the football because you're running out of time.
Cody West is going to keep it himself. And a nice pickup.
The wing T is designed as the quarterback has the ability to keep the ball and make gains. So it works more in the Riverdale's favor, actually.
Doyle and DeQuentin Sherrill is in motion. Sherrill as close as all of these teams are, as tight as this district has been, it's still tied 7-7 in the fourth. Fumbled and then is pushed back to the fourth.
Snap that's gone awry, and again this Cody West came out of there, his hands ringing wet.
Dietrich is standing at the 10. Nice punt. Rolls into the end zone. Touchback.
Even the players are.
Dietrich, near side receiver. believe that's Jalen Smith, far side. In the eyes, Collier. And it's Mathers wrapped up at the
You guys said whoever makes the last mistake may end up paying the price. So we'll see.
Donnie Johnson is on the sidelines tonight for Steve Martin Construction. Going right side with it. Nobody can get freed up over there. Mathers into the second quarter. The bottom fell out. And it's been steadily raining since. Handoff. Hit in the backfield is Mathers. Our Home Mortgage. Paleo's Grill on Broad Street. And Bob Parks, auctioneer Bob Bug. Ready for the Jason Poor punt. Snap is low to him. He picks it up through a puddle and a splash. Odom is going to pick it up at his 44-yard line, and that's where
7-7 here. Weather played a factor in a lot of places tonight.
Absolutely. Cody Weston's a man in motion, and he bobbled the snap. I'm not sure who has the football. Blackman has it at the 44 of Riverdale. Seven-seven, your score. Collier to Smith, slung down. The Riverdale 48 for the Blackman Blaze with a minute 51 left in regulation, tied at 7 apiece. Blackman moving right to left as we see it. Faking the handoff. Collier back to pass over the middle and dropped by Dietrich. Dietrich is hit and then slide.
Going to hit your pads. You've got to kind of like cradle it, then grab it, you know, because it's just the ball's too wet. Your hands are too wet.
Third and 15.
Did that make any sense? It was about an hour and a half long.
I think it did. I was with you. Ball is fumbled on the snap. It's going to be either fourth down or Riverdale football. I think Collier got back on it, I think. Yes.
That was a strategy on taking that delayed game penalty, and here comes a crucial snap.
And it's low, and Poor gets it off. It kind of dribbled to him, and now dribbles down to the 12, like overtime. Riverdale, Hendersonville, John, that game went into extra stanza. The Oakland game was overtime with Innsworth, and the Oakland Riverdale game. Just fitting that this may happen. Cody West on the quarterback sneak up the middle. Are going to be playing in the left end zone as we look at it from right to left. Most of this game has been played on the concession stand end here at Riverdale, so this end
a little better field
is a little better. Collier sets him down. First and goal from the 10. In overtime, Mathers right up the gut, loses the football into the end zone. It's going to be picked up by Dietrich. Touchdown, Blaze! Wow.
Talk about.
Now for the extra. Jason Poor.
This is kind of big here, too. This is. And these won't be guarantees.
Jason lining it up. A couple of steps to the left. Digs in. Snap, set, kick, up, and it's good. 14.
Brakes, fluids, and more.
Come by for our $24.99 oil change special, complete with tire rotation. That's right.
Only $24.99 for an oil change and tire rotation.
$24.99 for an oil change.
Going right side is Walter.
Got more yardage than that. Big break for Riverdale. That really helped.
Two extra yards. They'll take it. Cody West on the second and goal from the two. West handoff going to Davenport. Keeps the legs churning. Does he break the plane? He does not. Third down.
Got to the one. That's
third and goal from the one. West rolls him out. With Gaines and Davenport in the backfield, Cody West is going to keep it. And touchdown, Warriors! Touchdown, West, from the one. It's a tough call.
I believe something will happen maybe before that decision has to be made, Brian.
Let's go down to Donnie real quick on the sidelines. Don?
Well, guys, I was just wondering if they're going to go for two or not here, and I think they're going to go for two, fellas.
That's what it looks like. Riverdale going to go for two.
Win or lose, right? Lose it right here.
They're putting it on the line. A gutsy call. Cody West brings him out here. West fakes, goes right side, is brought down, and the Blackman Blaze are district champions. The Blackman Blaze are winners. The Blaze win it in overtime, 14-13. In overtime, Blackman is a winner. And bedlam ensues.